This is Menno Verstig from Canada. I'm a musician, and I wrote a song about my grandfather. His life was saved by your grandfather.
I wrote this interesting story about the relationship of our two grandfathers.
My grandfather's name was Carl Verstig, and he was definitely one of my closest friends. When I was a kid, I used to love listening to his stories about his childhood growing up in Holland and how his life changed so drastically when the war started. On the day that he died, I wrote a song called So It Goes. It just absolutely poured right out of me. It came even before any tears. And it's about his time fighting in World War II. The Germans invaded Holland in 1940 and everything changed for the Dutch people. The Germans completely leveled the city of Rotterdam with bombs. They left nothing. They obliterated the entire city. They took over their businesses, they took over the schools, they took over the banks. They even renamed all the streets to have German names so none of the Dutch people could find their way around. My grandfather, he immediately joined the Dutch resistance. They were doing whatever they could to survive. They were robbing German banks. They were smuggling weapons. They were forging documents. In fact, my grandfather was a great forger, and he forged a document that said that he was a veterinarian. This enabled him to move about the city and conduct operations for the resistance. But the problem was that he had no clue about veterinary medicine, and the Germans would often hire him to heal a sick dog or a sick horse. And he had no clue what he was doing, so he kind of just hoped they got better on their own. So after a while, when enough horses and dogs had eventually died under my grandfather's care, they realized that he was probably a member of the resistance, and he was captured. He was supposed to be executed immediately, but instead of being executed, he was handed over to this German officer who chose to speak to him, soldier to soldier. And in speaking with him, my grandfather said, "Listen, if you were in the same situation that I'm in, if your country has just been occupied by another country, if your city was Rotterdam and it was on fire, if it had just been leveled to the ground, what would you do?" And the German officer said to him, "I would do the exact same thing that you're doing. I would fight back." So instead of executing him, he put him in prison, in solitary confinement, in a place called the Orange Hotel for 2 years. For me, the story really gets heavy after the war because this German officer who spared my grandfather's life was on trial for his own life. And my grandfather went to his trial and he told this story. He testified on behalf of his enemy. And my grandfather's testimony ended up saving the life of the German officer. I really wanted to travel to Holland to experience for myself the places where these events took place. And I also wanted to find out if there was a relative of the German officer, and it turns out there is.
I also was a little relieved that my grandfather also saved lives, and I want to say thank you to you and your grandfather.
If there's any way that I could meet up with you, I would love to just have a drink and meet you.
If we can meet in Germany, for me, no problem.
Although he's a person I would totally consider a random person on the other side of the world who I would normally never meet, our lives are intertwined in such an interesting way. And if our grandparents hadn't have met each other in this awful time and had the opportunity to speak to each other and develop a mutual respect for each other, then neither I nor the grandson of the German officer would even be alive today.
Of unopposed German bombers flew low over the center of Rotterdam and methodically bombed it into a heap of rubble.
Forgiven, but I-
way to tell what he felt when he was in here. I know for the rest of his life he woke up with nightmares. He would howl in his sleep, and people would always ask him why, and he would talk about his time in here. He would just say, being on your own gives you a lot to think about. You can't make peace without an enemy. You can't be forgiven without sin. We're all looking for love that's gonna set us free. But first you must forgive the man you've been.
The fact that both him and I are alive today and able to meet up and have a drink and share a laugh, that's such an incredible reason to celebrate.
Thanks for coming from Canada via Holland to Germany. I also want to thank you in front of the camera for my family that your grandfather testified on behalf of my grandfather. So I think now really the circle is closing.